Hi everyone, it's Emily Francis with Oh My Malta. On the greatest fishing boat in the world, I'm obsessed with the Malta fishing boats, and I never thought I would be inside one. But today, we have Andre with us, who is the grandson to Valencio, who let us watch him pull in the Lampuki. So I want to first introduce you, thank you for being here and giving us your time. And I want to ask you, there are two different ways to catch Lampuki. Can you briefly describe both?
Yeah, that's one way, it's our way. We catch the Lampuki with the line. We go near the coast, we find Lampuki.
This is the line?
Yeah, yeah. This is the line. There will be bottles, there will be the line hooks attached to it. And we attach mackerel, squid to the hooks, and then we bait it and we throw it in the water to catch Lampuki.
What's this for?
For to put in the sea so it won't go down. Okay. It stays in the upper part of the water.
So this is what floats for a line fishing.
Yeah.
So if somebody doesn't know anything about this, would the bucket go down then because it has all the fish hanging from it, mackerel?
No, it won't go down. Because we had floats here. Every 10 meters, you have a float.
Every 10 meters. And then on a larger boat for Lampuki, they go much further. They're not on the coast, right? How far out do they go?
About the first float will be about 30 miles from the coast. And then the last float, they go about 150.
150 miles from the coast.
So I saw on the large boats when we were here the first time, they didn't use these. They had it looked like pillowcases wrapped in palm leaves. What is that?
Those are the floats. They put the jablo in flower cases, and then they will wrap it up with rope.
Okay, and when do you start preparation before you go out for the first fishing day? So tell me about a larger fishing boat, more commercial fishing. What would they do to catch Lampuki?
So they go to meet up the floats about 30 miles from the coast. They will put the net around the float.
How do they put the net, sorry?
With their boat.
But with the big stones?
Yeah. No, there will be the float there from before. Okay. The net, they will go around it. So they will have the float here. And they go with the net around it, with the boat.
Okay.
And then they will haul up the net. And if there will be Lampuki under the palm, they will catch.
And I've heard that the Lampuki taste different, closer to the coast than out further.
Yeah, our Lampuki will taste more different from theirs. Because we catch it with the hook, and we'll put it in the freezer. And then they will rest about 3 days out there in the water on sea.
Oh, further out, rest 3 days. But you guys
about 10, in 5 hours, we'll come here.
But Lampuki tastes different because you're closer to the coast and it's only caught for 3 hours before it comes in and is served at the shop.
Yes.
3 to 6 hours. So if you were a new person to Malta, if you were a tourist, you would want to come to Marsa Schlock, of course, to get Lampuki, and you would want to get it from where?
From our shop. The Lampuki that we catch with the hooks, it tastes more good, but the others is good.
It's good.
It'll be on Sunday at the square. My uncle and my mom, they will be there every Sunday. My uncle is called Roman, and he'll have nice fresh fish every Sunday.
So this is a family tradition, so it was passed down through your father and grandfather and your grandfather's grandfather, and that's how you know the secrets. And that's how these beautiful, very special boats are still in use out here in Marsa Schlock. I want to tell you just really quickly, or you that are listening, Lampuki in Malta is the baby form of mahi-mahi if you are American. So this is the beginning of the season, they're babies here. And then they travel through and make it to the Atlantic Ocean, whoever has survived it, and they become what is known as, it's dolphin, but it's not the dolphin that you think of. And it's a much larger fish by the time they make it to the Atlantic, and then we call it mahi-mahi. So thank you, Andre, for granting us this interview. Next, we're gonna talk to your Aunt Natasha and take the fish inside. We have the woman who makes it all happen, Natasha. Her father is the fisherman who brought the Lampuki that you will see on this video. So Natasha, Let me know, what is the process once your father arrives on shore? Because there's a lot of things to do once he arrives.
Yes.
So what do we do when the boat gets here?
I come for the fish over here. I will take it to hotel home. Then we make it in the cases.
Okay.
We make some ice on it.
Okay.
And then we have to put it in the fridge.
But when I saw you were pulling in like a lot of nets and a lot of cases, and it was a lot of hard work.
Yes, then I come back here, over here on the boat, because of the sun, we take it in the garage, and I will make the net, or in the boat, or in the garage.
And then once we get to the garage, we pull out fish by fish.
Yes.
And then I saw people straightening them.
Yes.
Just to make sure that they, for what purpose?
No, because we make it like good, because if it's not good, it doesn't make the ice in between of them. So they take the ice if you make it good. If they, you know, make it good, the ice don't go in it.
And then you clean the fish.
Yes.
So you actually cleaned my piece of lampooki for me to eat tonight.
Yes.
And you sliced it down the bottom of the belly.
Yes.
And then you pulled everything out. Natasha, you have made this possible for us. Thank you so much.